Notice that given this table that tells us what the probabilities are for the weather tomorrow given the weather today, we can now fill out a table that tells us what the weather will be the day after tomorrow given the weather today, or what the probabilities will be. Okay? Now, how would we do that? Well, we know that we want this vector for day number two, and we know that that's the transition matrix times the state on day one. So we get this right here. Okay. But we know how to compute what that vector is for day one from the vector for day zero. Okay. Now, if computing a matrix vector multiply and taking the result of that and plugging it into another matrix vector multiply is a linear transformation, which is something that we're going to look at this week, then we know that there should be a matrix that represents it. Okay. What we're going to see this week is that the result of this right here, which is known as a matrix-matrix multiply, is that matrix, but you don't know yet what matrix-matrix multiplication is. How might you compute that? Well, you know how to determine columns of a matrix. You know that that's a matter of plugging in the unit basis vectors and seeing what comes out. So you can plug in the first unit basis vector, do this multiplication, take the result of that and do this multiplication, and out pops the first column of that transition matrix going from today to the day after tomorrow. So we can then take that result of that and plug it in right here. And we can do the same thing to come up with the other columns. Okay, what we've just been discussing in this unit is a simple example of a Markov process. What I want you to do is go and look up what this is, maybe on Wikipedia, and maybe you can go and see if you can find other examples of practical Markov processes and share these on the discussion board.